I want to talk to you about what's going on with Othello.
What do you mean?
Word travels fast in this business.
So you want to give me a pep talk? Sorry your life's going down the toilet. Hang in there, kiddo.
Not exactly. But I'll tell you one thing, you're not going to accomplish anything by feeling sorry for yourself. Life's not fair. So what? Get over it.
You know, you have a very interesting bedside manner, might I add.
I'm not your best friend, MP. I'm not here to coddle your ego. I'm here to put the best team possible on the floor, and I can't do that if you get shipped out because you gave up.
Who said I'm giving up? I'm not allowed to be upset.
You're allowed to be upset. But you need to channel that energy in a positive way. Play like your life depends on it and make it impossible for Othello to trade you.
Yeah, well, that's easier said than done.
Look, I'm only going to say this once, so listen up. I've been in this game a long time. I didn't get to where I'm at by playing games. When you're where you're at, there's a temptation to try to play things out in the press. All right, well, that might work for the top 1% of players in the league. But for everybody else, it backfires. I'm not saying you don't have that kind of talent, but it's too early in your career to pull that kind of power play. All you can do is produce, and I can help you produce. You just got to trust me.
Coach, I trust you. I just don't think I'm good enough. I mean, right now, I feel like my only choice is to get my hands dirty.
That's not who you are, MP.
No disrespect, Coach, but how do you know that? I'm only 21 years old. I don't even know who I am yet. Not fully. How do you know that's not me?
Look, I can't tell you what to do. You're your own person, and you got to make your own decisions. All I can do is give you my perspective. What you do with it, that's up to you.
I can respect that.
And I promise you, if you do this the right way, I'll do everything in my power to help you to succeed. But if you want any help with the other way, I can't do anything for you.
I hear you, Coach. That's totally fair.
Good. Now go out there and prove Othello wrong.
And to the surprise of some league observers, a number of rookies are already making huge contributions, Grant.
And it's so much fun to see these young players stepping up, getting thrown right into the fire, and for good reason. When you have two or three stars eating up your salary cap, you need the guys on rookie contracts to perform, and they are.
Let's take a look at our starters for the Golden State Warriors. Green and Looney together inside. Then it's Klay Thompson. Then there's Stephen Curry. And it's AI in at the two-guard spot.
And Looney's a guy you can rely on both ends of the floor.
Outside Monk. Mitchell, the pass to Sabonis. And here's Monk. Unloads. It's wide right. Hits off the rim. To the paint. Thompson gets it to go.
Klay reading the floor that time nicely and just took advantage of the soft D on the interior.
Outside Monk. Pass to Barnes. On the wing, Mitchell. Down to five on the shot clock. The baseline, Jay. And Sabonis the bucket on the assist by Mitchell.
And that's what makes Sabonis such a tremendous offensive player. He will score from all three levels.
Curry finds Green. To the middle. Here's AI. So it'll be two free throws. He was fouled in the act of shooting. Well, Brent, this Kings franchise looking to turn things around. It's been years since they've contended.
Yeah, B.A., you don't ever really want to get specific with win totals on a year, but how nice would it be for the Kings to hit that 40 win mark and try to get themselves into the postseason? Just hoping this recent coaching change will give them that boost to finally have some postseason basketball in Sacramento.
Both good from the line that time.
after a couple of injury-plagued seasons where they missed the playoffs, the Warriors have returned to their winning ways, and just how impressive has that been?
Now here's Monk, 17 points in his last outing. Now Barnes. Sabonis outside. Barnes against Thompson. And the foul called on Harrison Barnes. That's his first foul of the game.
And this kind of selflessness is great to see. Textbook positioning to draw the charge.
Right, and getting Klay Thompson back has been a major factor for their renewed success.
There's no doubt how vital Klay is to this team, but you got to give credit to their overall depth. I don't think Klay was fully healthy last year at any point, so he's coming in stronger. This roster still feels like strength in numbers is in effect.
Now here's Barnes doing some damage on the offensive end, putting up a little over 14 points a game. Here's Mitchell. Here's Sabonis. Let's it go from deep. And that one's good. Mitchell for three.
And it's such a strong part of what Sabonis brings to the game. Quality passing.
Curry against Mitchell. Baseline try. And he can't get that one. So the Kings will take it the other way. A tough loss coming against the Lakers in their last game played.
If you can't match up on the boards, you are not going to win games. That's got to be a big lesson from that game.
Well, maybe they went into that game thinking rebounding not something they needed to focus on. They absolutely did.
Oh, and a fast break for the Warriors. Here's Thompson. He's in his comfort zone. Two for two to start this one.
I mean, he can just put in difficult shots from time to time, not affected at all by the contact.
Outside Barnes. Murray passes to Monk. Here's Sabonis. Two shots, two makes. Off to a good start.
I love this approach. Getting him involved early, and it's already paying off.
Well, he's going to just keep going now. That's early confidence for him.
Now here's Thompson. Coming off a 22-point game against Cleveland. And play stops. A whistle there on what looks like an illegal screen.
You can get away with one once in a while, but it looked like he wasn't completely set on that pick.
Yeah, a quick little lean like that is going to get the ref's attention. Foul called.
Here's Monk. Well, he hasn't put up any points yet in this one. Here's Mitchell. Oh, a clear foul there on the missed shot. So he'll get a pair at the line.
The first thing I think of when watching Davion Mitchell is defense. Mitchell entered the league as one of the best on-the-ball defenders out there.
And the free throw is good, now leading by one. And no doubt, Davion Mitchell is an elite defensive guard. Why is that, Grant?
Well, B.A., despite standing 6 feet, he's got a 6'5 wingspan. Mitchell is really strong and quick. But the biggest thing, Davion never takes a possession off. And they may have talked about shot selection coming into this.
Outside Monk.
Warriors foul. Castillo, first personal foul. Second team foul.
Sabonis finds Monk. On the wing, Mitchell. Cash money on the open jump shot. Mitchell's got seven.
That's the kind of passing you want there. Work the ball around, keep it moving, try to get an assist on every bucket.
Here's Green. The rebound by Murray. Murray's got four rebounds now. Pass to Mitchell. Now here's Monk. Outside Barnes. Shot clock at six. Here's Sabonis. And there's the bucket. Staying with it that time. Offensive glass getting it done.
And you hear a lot about Murray's activity, especially on the glass. I mean, he never stops working. Gets a lot of second chance points opportunities.
Here's AI. And right now, he's currently putting up 6.5 points per game. Golden State needs to get off a shot. And Looney with the slam.
Man, Looney is so long. Gets up there and flushes it.
The Kings have gone 5 of 9 from the floor. Mitchell, the pass to Monk. Now here's Barnes, defended by Thompson. Knocks it loose. Now here's Monk. Defense is right there. Ooh, and he took a hard foul on the shot. So he'll head to the line to shoot a pair. Kevon Looney picks one up.
13. At the line for your Kings, Malik Monk.
That one's off.
One thing the Kings got when they hired Mike Brown is a coach who's been through and seen it all with his NBA coaching experience.
And the Warriors making a change here. Green is checked in. Thompson outside. Pass to AI. Down low. And it's hammered home by Green.
Yeah, undersized guys with athleticism do these kind of things, playing above the rim. Love to see him get up like that.
When it comes to Mike Brown, he's been an assistant or a head coach for six different teams now, Brent.
That's a lot of different kitchens to be in, B.A., and as an assistant, he's worked for great coaches, Greg Popovich, Steve Kerr, Rick Carlisle. It's a great group of coaches to draw upon and then add his own styles in and what he wants to do with this Kings team moving forward.
And Sabonis slams it in.
Yeah, Sabonis just cleaning the board, taking care of business. That's just too easy if you're the defense.
Pass to AI. Back to Curry. Launches it. Knocks down the long J. And the Warriors lead by one.
You know, sometimes basketball is not all that complicated. Just let Stephen Curry shoot threes and get out of the way.
Now here's Mitchell. He's got seven. Back to Barnes. Outside Monk. Shoots over Thompson. And too long on the shot.
That's a shot he'd like, Mac. He's usually going to make those.
And the Warriors with another three.
3 points.
The Kings have got half their attempts to go. 6 of 12. Timeout called. Sacramento. And watching Draymond Green play, Grant, he's the quarterback on both ends.
I love that, B.A. Defensively, constantly calling out instructions on how to switch, keeping everyone organized. And offensively, Green is an incredible passer.
Mitchell and Monk, they're the backcourt. Up front, it'll be Murray and Sabonis. And it's Barnes in at the three. That's the five out there for the Kings. Outside Mitchell. Here's Murray, coming off a 31-point game against the Lakers.
It felt like in that game, too, he was a man on a mission defensively. Finishing up with four steals is an impressive feat. And you could tell, takes pride in that part of the game.
Golden State has gone 7 of 11 from outside the arc. Nice percentage from distance so far. Here's AI. Monk covers. Shoots a fadeaway. And the Warriors tack on two more.
Well, if the defense is going to back up that much, Draymond's got to step into the mid-range shot. And he took it that time.
Second quarter of basketball. About a minute played so far. Pass to Monk. Jacks up a three. That one is off. And Golden State will go the other way with it. Here's AI. And here's Curry. Checked by Mitchell. Here's AI. Just five to shoot. Back to Green. And the shot's good.
Draymond Green.
Green's got his second basket on the night.
It's where Draymond's speed becomes a huge advantage as he gets off the pick and roll and guys can't keep up with him.
And that streaking rack attack is the Mobile One Drive.
You're toasting the defense and getting in close. They'll take possessions like that one all day.
Outside Barnes. No good. Thompson with some nice D. Here's AI. Monk covers. And that one's good. AI. And the Warriors lead by 21. Things just don't seem to be clicking for them offensively.
Yeah, they really need to find a way to get back on track.
Murray finds Monk. The three from Barnes. Again, the miss by the Kings.
It's tough to get open in this league, and when you do, it hurts not to capitalize.
Here's Thompson. Pass to AI. Looney with the ball. He's guarded by Sabonis. And he comes up with a bucket.
I just love the ball movement.
Sacramento has gone 0-for-2 from outside in the second quarter. Outside Monk. Oh, they get a hand on it. Here's the break. Here's AI. Oh, a huge slam! An exclamation point on that break.
Balanced play has given them the lead and also quieted this crowd.
Well, all night long, in control of the pace, and you don't want to let go of that rope right now.
Timeout call, Sacramento. And the league has redefined the rules a bit regarding the gather step. Players getting more leeway. What do you think about that?
Well, I think guys BA are getting a little more creative in practicing that. I mean, they will adjust to the rule. That is one thing we've seen through the years with NBA players. And so in the offseason, if you can find a way to take advantage of a half a step more in order to gain advantage on a defender, I'm all for it until they change the rule back.
Kicks it out to Barnes. Stolen by Thompson. Outside, Green. And the foul is called. He missed it, so he's got a couple of free throws coming his way.
Yeah, we know he's undersized for the position, but Draymond Green does the work of several men, including how he forces the D that time of foul.
And that one misses.
Yeah, you know, after a couple down years with key players injured, it's safe to say the Golden State Warriors are back.
And he's good on the second. The Warriors are back to contending for championships.
Yes, they are. A testament to their perseverance and belief in themselves. They knew once they got healthy, they would be a threat. And they've been a fun team to watch as they get back to form.
Outside for Mitchell. And they call an illegal screen here.
And in the last two possessions, they've painted a picture of what not to do. Just way too loose with the basketball.
Now the Warriors with it. They've picked up 11 straight. Thompson outside. Back to Curry. Pass to AI. To the inside. Soft touch off the glass. Looney's got 4 points in the quarter.
They're really working the paint now.
Outside Monk. Curry against Mitchell. Six to shoot. Murray. Oh, he hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points.
Yeah, and great awareness from Murray. I mean, he gets up there and sends the ball right back down.
Pass to AI. Puts it up. And the Warriors get it back. Looney passes to Green. Over Murray. Here's Looney. And at last, they get one to fall. Looney's got 12 points in the game.
This run has been fueled by their Matador defense.
Monk against Looney. And it's Monk missing.
Aggressive mindset, but the defender just as determined to send him away empty-handed.
Pass to AI. Inside. Monk with a steal. Mitchell with the ball. Now guarded by Curry. Oh, it's blocked by Green.
Wow, gritty defense from Draymond, showing how tough it is, and great timing on the rejection.
Yeah, the shocker of the 2022 trade deadline. A deal centered around Domantas Sabonis going to Sacramento and Tyrese Haliburton sent to Indy.
First free throw is good. That blockbuster Sabonis-Haliburton trade, what do you make of it for the Kings?
Well, you know, B.A., Sacramento was a guard-heavy team. Sabonis adds size. He also adds playmaking, and I love his motor. I think it was a move to even out their roster.
That one falls, so he hits both of them.
Yeah, they're really cashing in more at the line here in the second quarter.
Offensively, it's been a struggle for them.
Yeah, they need to string together some shots to have any kind of chance.
Monk finds Mitchell. Outside Monk. Five to shoot. Out of bounds. It'll be Warriors ball.
I know people can't see you, but you're doing what I'm doing
for the Warriors.
Scratching your head to that.
Gary Payton.
Payton's checked in for the Warriors. Now the Warriors with it. What a stretch they've got going here. 17-2. Back to Looney. To the paint. Here's Curry. And he floats it in for the easy two. Credit the sweet setup on that one.
And they've really managed to dominate inside.
Outside Barnes. Back to Mitchell. Monk for three. And the rebound goes to the Warriors. Looney's got 8 rebounds in the game.
They've had a slight leg up on the boards and a big leg up on the scoreboard.
And it's out of bounds. They say it was last touch by Sabonis.
Almost had the steal. You have to love the pressure defense.
Yeah, pestering right now, and that's going to pay some dividends. At some point, there's going to be a turnover.
Herter's checked in for Monk. Green, the pass to Looney. Back to Green. Over Murray, and it's Green missing.
Well, his shooting has been a little bit below par. You think about what this lead would look like if he was on.
Pass to Barnes. Three-pointer. Sinks it from distance. Barnes has got his first 3 points of the game.
Nice ball movement. Good job by Murray to recognize the situation and create the wide-open look.
Thompson outside. Tried to come right back with a three of his own, but it's no good. Curry against Mitchell. Shoots over Curry, and it's Mitchell. The miss. Golden State with the ball. They're on a 19-5 run. Pass to Curry. Down low. Here's Payton. That drops, and it comes off an assist from Curry.
They're winning the battle down low by imposing their will.
Sacramento has gone 1-4 from three-point land here in the second. Mitchell, the pass to Barnes. Now Sabonis. He's defended by Looney. Outside Herter. Here's the three. Another three for Sacramento.
They've got some ground to make up, and shooting the three ball more consistently, like they are now, should help them do it.
Pass to Looney. Here's Thompson. Herter defending. Now Green. Great D that time from Murray.
Yeah, this has not been a good quarter right here. Shot has been off the mark, and now it looks, Kevin, like he's pressing a bit.
Barnes passes to Sabonis. And he was camped in the lane there. He gets a 3-second call.
Talk about a way to deflate the team.
Yeah, he knows he shouldn't have made it, and that's just really overall a frustrating sequence that hopefully doesn't stick with him.
Lyles, he's checked in for Sacramento. He's checked in for the Warriors. Poole comes in for Stephen Curry. Pass to Wiggins. Fires the three. Nails it from beyond the arc. Wiggins has got 11 points.
When Wiggins is shooting it with confidence, man, he's a threat to put up some big numbers.
Here's Lyles. Outside Barnes. Here's Lyles. Currently averaging 5 points a game. Clock at four. And he's going to the line for two. The official saw contact while he was going up.
Personal foul.
Klay Thompson picks one up.
Harrison Barnes continues to be a consummate professional. Goes out and competes every night. Gives you everything he's got.
Two shots.
That free throw good from Barnes. You know, back in 2010, Harrison Barnes was the top recruit in the country out of high school, Graham.
Yeah, and interestingly, Barnes decided to play two seasons at North Carolina. Unheard of these days for someone with Harrison's pedigree.
Metu, he's checked in for Sacramento. Davis comes in for Mitchell. Green's checked in for the Warriors. Kuminga comes in for Klay Thompson. And he can't hit the second.
Well, the league's attitude towards the mid-range shot has changed quite a bit, and Harrison Barnes may reflect that more than anyone.
Here's Wiggins. It's deflected. Barnes against Kuminga. Oh, and he got fouled on his way up. He'll head to the line to shoot two.
First personal foul.
Now, with Barnes, it wasn't too long ago that he really relied on the mid-range jumper.
Yeah, B.A., you go back just a few seasons to 2017, and he was in the league's top 10 in mid-range attempts. And now you just don't ever see him operate there. It's either threes or getting all the way to the rim. So the shot diet for HB has changed. And Chemezi, drafted in 2018, spent his first few seasons grinding it out in the G League, trying to prove himself until he got that contract in 2021.
Both shots good from the strike. And for Metu, ask his teammates. They'll tell you just how hard of a worker he is.
Yeah, it's been a constant theme, B.A. You know, Chemezi graduated college in 3 years with a degree in law, history, and culture, all while playing at USC.
Pass to Poole. Played it in with a nice Jordan touch Poole off the window. Poole's got 11.
They just look so overwhelmed inside. Yeah, that's why they continue to get attacked.
And here's Davis. Back to Herter. Here's Lyles. Davis finds
Two
Herter.
2 minutes remaining in the first half. 2 minutes.
Over Poole. Herter gets the bucket. Herter's got 5 points now this quarter.
Hard to stop with how quick Herter is able to rise.
Poole, the pass to Wiggins. Davis against Payton. Outside, Green. Back to Payton. And that one's good. And Green with the assist.
Time.
Up 25 big ones as we head into the next period. And they've racked up a ton of turnovers. Back to the game after this break.
The Warriors, 68. Fans, your Kings, you dance team.
Drama in the first half, but maybe things will tighten up here in the second. How about Andrew Wiggins? Man, is he playing well.
Through the first two quarters and change, his perimeter shooting continues to be spot on.
Yeah, you would hope the defense at least would start to consider creeping up on him just a little bit.
And so in the game for the Warriors, Green and Looney together inside. Then there's Stephen Curry. Then it's Klay Thompson. And it's AI in at the shooting guard. Here's Barnes. And he got the whistle on the way up. So he'll be headed to the line for a pair.
Second personal foul.
Klay Thompson picks one up.
And Harrison Barnes in great body control on that possession, just working against the defender.
And the second free throw is good. And Grant, so much young talent for the Warriors. Many said they should trade for veterans, but they resisted.
And they won a title anyways. I mean, with the salary cap perhaps their greatest obstacle, having contributors on cost-controlled rookie contracts sure helps.
Here's Curry. Pass to AI. Pulls up, high post. Here's Looney. Oh, he remains perfect. 7 for 7, showing no signs of letting up.
Looks like we're starting to see a pattern here. Not afraid to get in the paint and get wet.
Now here's Monk. Back to Mitchell. It's Monk on the wing. And they recover it. Pass to Barnes. 4-3. Rebounded by Green.
Still looking for his first make, and they could really use the help right now.
AI. Second shot opportunity, and it's finished off inside by Green. Green's got 7.
Well, Draymond doesn't just come down with the rebound. He goes right back up aggressively to score.
Knocked loose. And he was fouled while in the act of shooting, so he'll take 2 free throws.
Third personal foul. First team foul.
The first one falls.
And the number 4 overall pick, Keegan Murray, making a quick impact. One of the most efficient players in college basketball at Iowa last year. He went on to win MVP of the 2K23 Summer League. Can he become a rising star for the Kings? It'll be fun to watch.
To the middle. He can't get it to go. Nice D from Sabonis. Mitchell against Curry. Pass to Monk. And the rebound goes to the Warriors. Looney's got rebound number 11.
Bad offense to begin the second half. 4 misses right off the bat. Like a matador. Ole! There was no defense. That has to be one of the easier shots I've seen tonight.
Yeah, feels like Christmas right now, just gift wrapping points.
Outside Mitchell. Back to Sabonis. Clock at 6. Outside Murray. Over Looney. He got a piece of it.
Looney's starting to play a little bit angry right now. That's helping this defense be more aggressive.
And you got to be in awe of incredible defensive efforts like this.
Showing no signs of giving up this lead. That block sent shockwaves into the opposition sails.
Pass to AI. To the inside. And Looney with the slam. Looney.
Maybe didn't see this one coming, but Looney right now effective on the offensive end.
For Sacramento, they've gotten off to a rough start. Now 0-for-5 in the second. Back to Mitchell. Over Curry. And it's Mitchell. The miss.
Nice rebound. Trying to match the other team's intensity right now.
Off target with the 3. Sacramento has gotten nothing to fall from outside in this third quarter. Looney against Monk. To end the drought. And he sinks the layup.
Terrific design and execution, leading to an opportunity right at the rim.
Outstanding dribble drive. And that replay was brought to you by Mobile One.
Yeah, they have a long way to go, but attacking the rim like that is a great way to start a comeback.
And that one's good. AI.
Yeah, their defense is starting to wear down. That's 3 straight buckets at the rim.
Boy, they need something to go to regain some confidence.
No question. Way too many empty possessions for them.
Mitchell, the pass to Barnes. Monk for 3. It's rebounded by Golden State.
Hate to say it, but if they're still trailing at the final buzzer, a lot of this is going to be felt by Stephen him. His shooting tonight has just been atrocious.
He drops yet another dime, just facilitating this offense like a maestro.
Murray passes to Monk. Now here's Sabonis. He's defended by Looney. And so he draws the foul, headed to the line to shoot a pair. Well, Grant, the shocker of the 2022 trade deadline, Domantas Sabonis, going to the Kings.
Big-time surprise. Tyrese Halliburton going the other way to Indy. Now, I like that deal for both sides. Sacramento adding an all-star big. The Kings needing some size. Sabonis adds that.
So the Kings making a change here. Holmes has checked in.
Well, Sabonis is such a huge asset to this team. Plays the four and the five spot really well. Very good passer. And he's deserved the two All-Star appearances in the Eastern Conference.
All right, let's get a report from Allie.
Well, guys, the NBA markets itself behind its star players, but Commissioner Adam Silver understands what makes the game tick. He said, quote, this is a team sport. In order to truly win championships and compete at the highest level, all the players have to come together.
So true, Allie. Thank you. Now here's Mitchell. He has seven. Outside Monk. Shot clock at five. Sees the lob. And there's the shot clock violation. Couldn't get the shot off in time.
Can't get anything to go this period. Seems like he's hit a wall.
And here are the Warriors now. They're on a 14-4 run. Outside, Green. And a foul called on the way up. So he'll take two from the free throw line.
Personal foul.
And how about the impact that Sabonis has had thus far, Brett?
Well, the reliability, B.A., is down there on the glass and doing the dirty work, trying to grab those boards and get some scrappy points in the paint. That's what Sabonis is all about. So he's got the entire package as an inside player.
He hits the second from the line.
Amazing to think about Draymond Green and... the career arc he's had thus far. He really can guard any position on the floor. He can make plays. Really a unique talent.
Monk finds Mitchell. Holmes with it. Outside Monk takes a three. Gets rebounded by Golden State. Green's got five rebounds in the game.
It's been an ugly quarter for him. Trying to shoot his way out of it. Might be time to work on the playmaking skills.
2022, what a year for Golden State. Another NBA title.
Unbelievable. From the worst record in the league, climbing back on top, getting their big three healthy. Man, as long as you have a healthy Steph Curry, I think you're going to have a chance to get there. What a run they were on.
Herter's checked in for Murray.
Their lead could be even bigger right now. Their efficiency from the line has dropped off a little.
And a chance to catch up on some numbers here. The scoring breakdown for the Warriors.
Just a great job running the floor in transition. Now he realized they were tiring out the defense early, and they took full advantage.
Man, scoring off a turnover is so helpful. I mean, you get easy opportunities at the rim. It devastates the opponent. They've done a great job tonight at converting on those chances.
Here's Curry. It's rebounded by Sabonis. Sabonis has got his eighth rebound here tonight. Mitchell against Curry. Mitchell, the pass to Holmes. Shoots over Wiggins. Holmes, no good.
Well, he finds some space in that in-between gap there. Too bad he can't release that one on target.
Oh, and there's the whistle on the shot. So two free throws for him coming up.
Second personal foul. Fourth team foul. Shooting for Golden State.
He misses the free throw. So the Kings making a change here. Davis has checked in. Kuminga, he's checked in for the Warriors. Poole comes in for Stephen Curry. Sacramento shooting 37% from the floor at this point. Outside Monk. Pass to Sabonis. Outside Herter. It's Monk on the wing. Three-pointer. And the rebound goes to the Warriors.
Not a way to get out of a funk. He needs to be looking for good, solid, more efficient shots. Not the wild one he took there.
And I love how he's pushing the tempo and creating for others. He does this game in and game out. Incredible.
Nice to play with a point guard that takes pride in playmaking. It makes you move around just a little bit faster to get open spots.
Back to Davis. Looney with some nice D.
That's the shot you hope for, right at the rim. Just couldn't capitalize.
Yep, count it. Jordan Poole's got 13.
And no lack of confidence from Jordan Poole on a floater like that.
And it's the Kings with the ball. Next matchup, they'll be home against the Nets. And that'll be their second of four total games at home. Again, the miss by the Kings. Golden State has gone one of two shooting from the perimeter since halftime. Oh, and he got fouled on his way up. He'll head to the line to shoot two.
Third personal foul.
That one on Herter.
And Poole playing aggressive on the inside, just forcing the defense to come at him.
Brent, during his first year and a half in the league, Jordan Poole really struggled.
Yeah, it seems so long ago, but go back to that 2021 G League bubble time and those 22 points a game that Jordan Poole was pouring in. I think that was just such a shot of confidence into Jordan Poole's game, and since then we've just seen a vastly improved, more confident player. And Jordan Poole has stepped onto the NBA stage and not ever backed down from a challenge. He plays with tremendous confidence.
Pass to Lyles. Back to Monk. Can they get it? Kuminga pulls it in.
Sometimes you just have an off night, guys, and that's what we've seen so far.
And so he draws the foul, headed to the line to shoot a pair.
And Wiggins anticipated that one. He saw the foul coming, and he made sure to get that one off.
Shooting for Golden State, Andrew Wiggins at the line for two.
Some changes here for the Kings. Murray's checked in for Lyles, and it's Barnes in for Davis.
Shooting one.
He couldn't get to the line once in the first half. Coach must have really talked to him at the break.
The Warriors shooting an efficient 57% tonight. Up front, it'll be Murray and Sabonis. Malik Monk is out there with Kevin Herter, and it's Barnes in at the small forward position. That's the five out there for the Kings. Inside, and that one is hammered home!
They're really dictating the tempo on both ends of the court. We love it.
Yeah, the other team a bit concerned here. They're trailing, and the lead seems to be growing.
Monk passes to Barnes. Let's the three fly, and it's Monk that time on the assist from Barnes.
I mean, could we say he was playing possum a bit there in the first half? Because it seems to be a different guy out there, way more assertive.
Down low, here's Iguodala. Uses the glass on the layup.
He fights through some aggressive defense, Iguodala using those broad shoulders and not taking no for an answer.
Outside Monk. Murray against Iguodala. Up top Barnes. Uses the glass to finish the layup.
Attacking is one thing, but body control another, and Harrison Barnes showing you that on that play.
And no lack of aggression on that move. Good for the 2K drive. Here's AI. Monk covers. Here's AI. And that one hits the back iron. Sacramento has gone 2 of 6 so far in the fourth. The three ball. Barnes, and that's good. Barnes has got 5 points now this quarter.
They've been pretty lax with their perimeter defense, giving up a lot of three-pointers.
Here's AI. Monk covers. AI, no good. Sacramento has gone 3 of 7 from the perimeter during the fourth. And there it is for him.
Shooters tend to be hungry, but this time Herder finds an open teammate.
The Warriors shooting just a phenomenal clip, 59% here in the fourth.
2 minutes remaining.
Pass to Green.
2 minutes.
It falls again. He's now 8 for 12 from the floor.
And it only makes sense to give him the rock again. He put the team on his back all game.
Yeah, he's feeling it. Keep feeding him until he misses.
Outside Barnes. They kick it out to Murray. Late clock here. The Kings need to get one up. Offensive rebound. Sabonis. And it goes. As the official calls the foul. Count it. And he'll shoot one more at the line.
Andre Iguodala.
And a new group getting ready for the Kings. Lenz checked in for Murray. Edwards comes in for Barnes. Dozier's checked in for Herder. And it's Davis in for Monk. DiVincenzo, he's checked in for the Warriors. A minute 20 left in the final quarter with the drive.
And you can see how scary this team can be when everything is clicking for them. Just a terrific performance for the Warriors.
Well, Grant, I don't know if there was one deciding factor in this game, but I'd say shooting accuracy if I had to choose.
Agreed, B.A. They really went after quality looks and shot the ball with confidence.
And with this one, they go double digits in the win column.
It's just a great matchup for them. And they're looking for the four-game season sweep in their next meeting.
Sabonis is such a difficult guy to guard, and right now he is going off.
Here's AI. The shot no good. Now Sacramento takes it the other way. Ooh, ripped away! To the middle. Pass to Lamb. Here's AI. Checked by Davis. Here's AI. Here's Green. And he got the whistle on the way up. So he'll be headed to the line for a pair.
First personal foul. Third team. Shooting for Golden State, Jamichael Green, 2 shots.
And he knocks down the first one. And both free throws good for Green. 2 second difference between shot and game clock. Pass to Dozier. Back to Davis. Out to the wing. Here's Dozier. Fires from deep. Lamb grabs the miss. Iguodala left side. From deep, missed it, and so it's the Warriors taking care of business.
That's
in this
the end
one
of the game.
To walk into enemy territory and deliver a
Thank
performance like that, that says a lot about this squad.
They really came in looking confident and didn't let anything shake them. This is what a dominant team looks like.
Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. For Ali LaForce, Brent Berry, Grant Hill, and our entire 2K Sports crew, this is Brian Anderson signing off. We'll see you next time.
Oh, I'm hearing you're thinking about staying after all.
Yeah, things got a little emotional the other day, and this is where I want to be ultimately.
Great. Well, Now all we got to do is game plan.
Oh, wait. So Mila and I, we discussed, and we think we want to avoid the press in this. Just put my head down, focus, play the best basketball that I can play, because if Othello wants to trade me, he's going to be the one that looks like a clown, not me.
Okay, yeah, that is an option, but I don't think it's our best one here, man.
All right, then. Let me hear something.
Look, MP, you are a phenomenal player. I mean, you have unlimited potential, and you know I believe this, otherwise I wouldn't be here focusing all my energy on you like this. But right now, you've already got an uphill battle with the fans. And as it stands, if Othello leaks a trade rumor, you're going to have half this city dancing in the streets.
Oh, come on, man. You don't think that's just a little too extreme right now?
Research shows that sports fans are 78% more likely to dance in celebration than any other type of fan, and that includes fans of ballroom dancing, funny enough.
Thanks, Ash.
Look, I'm not saying you can't do the whole good soldier routine, but, dog, to play so well that a trade is impossible without doing any maneuvering in the press, I mean, that's extremely difficult.
Impossible.
Look, why don't you just play as well as you can while trying to work the press in your favor? I mean, it's the best of both worlds.
But isn't doing all that behind-the-scenes stuff bad for my brand?
Exactly.
Like, Ashley, what do you think?
Okay, it's a possibility that it could hurt your image, okay. But that is a very remote possibility, okay? No one will blame you for wanting to stay on your own team.
Mm-hmm.
It's okay. When you try to force your way out that there's a problem.
You know what? What if he's not comfortable trying to get another man fired?
Right. Okay.
I guess you guys haven't heard of the golden rule.
Oh,
treat others
rule,
as you would like to be treated.
Okay, fine. If that's the case, then we just won't do it at all. Does
that
sound good?
That's not what I'm saying. I'm just saying you must not believe in his talent very well.
Okay, well, in my professional opinion, if you
want to
control as many variables as possible, MP, you want to stay in this city, have a family with Mila like you plan to, you'll use every weapon at your disposal.
You can try and control all the things you want with all this shenanigans and still get traded. So it's how you want to sleep at night.
So it's really up to you, man. What are you feeling? You know how you want to play this?
Listen, I just don't want to leave anything up to chance.
MP.
Mila, I'm sorry, but it's my career. And I'm doing what I feel is right.
Okay, I just want to make sure you're doing this because you actually want to and not because you're feeling pressured.
No, I'm doing it because I feel like this is what I need to do for both of us. Trust me on this one, okay?
Okay. Then we'll do it.
All right. All right, Rick, talk to me.
Ashley.
The goal is to get the national press to call for Othello's ouster.
Okay.
But they take their cues from the local guys.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so first step is getting the guys on the beat on our side.
Yes, that's right. But it's not going to be easy. It's going to be a little tricky because we can't just, you know, come out and tell them that Othello's trying to trade you. I mean, at this point, if we do that, there'll be plenty of people in the city happy to see you go.
The key here is to make the case that Othello is a problem for the future of the franchise. That takes time, though.
All right, so walk me through it.
We start small.
Okay.
I'll set up a meeting with John Luck. You can tell him all about how Othello threw a temper tantrum over the idea of winning fans of the city.
Wait, but wouldn't doing an interview like that put me in a line of fire?
Yes, which is why you'll do the interview as an anonymous source. Mm. All right, no names, just facts.
Yeah. Okay. Let everyone know that it was a PR initiative from the top down and everyone was supposed to get on board.
Oh, everyone was supposed to get on board.
Right.
Except Othello.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. So plant the seed that he's not a team player. He does things his own way, even when it's a detriment to the team.
Right.
Ooh, this sounds good, man. What's next?
I'll call John. I'll explain what you're there to talk about. Tell him that it's off the record. That way, he has to talk to people inside the organization in order to publish. If you tell him where to sniff around, even a puppy dog like John Luck can find a bone.
So we really doing this, huh?
Oh, we really doing it.
Absolutely.
Are we doing it? And it's going to work, too.
It better work, man.
I'll text you after the meeting is set up. Meantime, wouldn't hurt to play a few great games.
Yeah. I'll see what I can do.
Yeah.
Mila, what do you think about this?
This is the way you want to go? It sounds like a good plan.
All right.
See you later, man.
Congrats on the win. You guys really smothered them on the defensive end tonight.
Yeah, man, we was all flying around on defense, causing havoc, man. Coach likes to call it controlled chaos. But, you know, the other team was clueless in what was going on.
Mm-hmm.
We on the other end dunking and stuff, you know?
Yeah, it looked like you in particular had a read on what the other team was trying to do.
Oh, yeah, you know, man, I trust these instincts, man. Scheme is one thing, but if I see a guy looking too hard, I'm a gamble to get that steal. And you saw it tonight, it works.
It did tonight, at least. Congrats.
Appreciate you.
Yeah. I'm a product of the block I lived in, the Pac, Nas's and Biggs. For raw, took my door across the George Washington Bridge. I was poor, but more shocked how the watching us live. I put a Fort Knox in my crib. I was the one they overlooked. Now it overbooked. Got them haters disappointed like what a more money, more problems. Jealous throwing looks. That's why every 100 bands I make. So my story to the world, so everything I afford came from me losing my brother and all the pain I absorbed. I'm down, all the members of got them lost on this road to success, and yes, it came at a cost, so don't confuse what you hear. I put these shoes in my ear, cause I wore the same pair, kicks to school for a year. I traded all to get my back, I realized that we gon' grind together just to get it back.
Hey, yo, life crazy, but
yeah,
real talk.
For the in my position, take care of your daughters. No matter what they choose to do, they aware what you taught them. My kids took my advice, cause I'm fair as a father. My next deal, I need a